yes. Now, I'd like to talk about one site there, on set along Bonifacio Street, where the clearance of the footing is very close to our pipeline, So, yes. Actually, the problem is our digging somewhere else in the pipeline, not in the site being mentioned, Tony. So there are two excavations there, and there might have been a bit of confusion, Tony.
Yeah, I'm listening. I'm trying to understand. It would have been much better if you and your people are actually here, because we did ask them to bring diagrams. But what we did get earlier, as by way of excusing themselves, was that you are not allowed to speak to us because of the potential lawsuit that's being prepared by the West Tower residents. So we're really in a cloud here. We don't understand. We don't understand exactly which excavation now you're referring to.
And there are two excavations, Tony. Yeah. And that's not true. It had nothing to do with that news about any lawsuit or something. Because this is purely engineering and a purely technical digging that we're looking at there. No? So I'd like that to be clarified. That is absolutely not true. Now, there are two diggings being done under the ramp. No? One is closer to the lower portion of the ramp, and the other one is at a higher portion and very near what they call Bonifacio Street. Yes. So what they're talking about, shoring and everything, that's along Bonifacio Street, and that job is not hampered at all. Yes. The other one that was hampered by the close of traffic is the other being closer to the start of the ramp. So there might have been a miscommunication somewhere there on the excavations.
Mm.
But that is true. The traffic is being, contained or what, to allow the excavation to proceed.
All right.
I hope that will clarify things, Tony. That the time we're not attending the invitation because of a reason that is not entirely accurate.
All right. Well, that actually confuses me even more. That confuses me a lot. Because I heard different. Before we went on the air, I heard different. But in any case, that's all oil under the bridge. Let me just say this.
I hope we were able to clarify.
Yeah, but let me just ask one more question, because we have Dr. Arcilla here. I mean, the team of geologists from UP did a superb job of trying to locate the leak. But then again, there were some discrepancies between the findings that of your contractors and the geologists we had from UP. How do you explain that? I mean, how come these contractors, with all their engineering skills, couldn't find the leak, but the geologists had simple boreholes using worms and found it?
Well, we were working simultaneously, Tony. We were both working using different technologies. And in fact, at the time that this borehole found something near the ramp, we were excavating two other boreholes wherein Dr. Arcilla suspected also the presence of fumes. No?
Yeah.
We were digging up during that morning, and fortunately, those two excavations did not show anything. We're happy with that. And then, of course, sometime during the afternoon, one of Dr. Arcilla's boreholes did show traces of petroleum, and we immediately transferred to that place, no? Yes.
All right.
Tony, was that clear, yes?
Yeah, well, we do appreciate it that you even contacted us and that you gave us all of these clarifications. Hopefully next time, maybe we can have you or other executives of FPIC on the show.
Yes, that will always be our pleasure, Tony.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Leonides Gallo Garde, the president of FPIC, explaining where exactly the shoring needs to be done. All right. That's Bonifacio Street?
Bonifacio Street.
And that's further down south?
Further down south, yes.
Yeah.
That's right.
Okay. I'm kind of confused, though. So are they still saying that there's no leak?
No, maybe let me just explain something, right? In the northern, what we have done, the exploratory wells that we did, is we did it parallel to all of the leaks, close and north of the west tower and then south, because we wanted to really delineate. Now, luckily for everybody, especially for FPIC, our wells in the Bonifacio Street don't show anything.
Nothing.
So it means that that part of the pipeline is probably not leaking. So what we have done is basically narrow down the area where the leaks are going to be happening.
Okay.
Now, going to your comment later on, we had seen this, that this is going to happen, because if the pipeline is going to be underneath the flyover, there are several things. Number one, that could have been the reason why it broke in the first place.
But sabi ng DPWH director, baka
hindi daw. Pero,
may clearance. So.
But what is the fact now? The fact is that outside of the flyover area, there's probably no leak that we've seen.
There's none.
And secondly, very important to understand is that, you know, with the bypass can be done totally avoiding the flyover area. So if you avoid that, then there's going to be no load problem on this bypass.
Right.
But I think they're studying that. I'm not an engineer, but just doesn't take rocket science to figure out.
Yeah.
Where it
took a geologist to figure it out.
Yeah, I mean, it's not only you. We had a very good team.
Okay,
but it was, you know, it wasn't easy. That's what I'm saying.
All right. Well, I'm pretty sure the Makati City government is very thankful at this point to what, you know, the UP NIGS people have done. Even FPIC, of course, I'm pretty sure also does appreciate it. So in the meantime, is your work done? Is your work over?
No, not yet.
What else is NIGS going to be doing?
One thing is this. Makati is interested to guarantee that the pipeline traversing the whole of Makati is not leaking. So what they're asking me is to actually do exploratory wells along the 7 kilometers length of the pipeline crossing Makati.
Yeah. So now, it's a 7 kilometer length.
Yeah, that's going to be a lot of wells.
That's a lot of wells. And do you know where these... where the pipe runs underneath? I mean, are there buildings, like, does it run under BPI or?
No, it doesn't run under BPI. It runs. I told the city engineer of Makati to give us a detailed map of where it's running, so
but
that
they
we can
do know
design.
Where it runs.
Hopefully, they know exactly where it runs, because the worst thing that can happen
is that they lost.
Or if you start drilling and then you hit the pipeline, you know, we have ground penetrating radar data. We have our own.
Yeah.
And before I do this wells, I'll probably be using that just to make sure.
Okay.
Now, why is that important? Because if the pig fails again, the wells will be there permanently. You can monitor this every month.
Oh.
So if a leak happens, you can actually catch it early.
So you can use them.
Oh yes,
they're not gonna be like holes that will be covered later.
No. The holes that we've dug. Are monitoring wells right now.
Oh, okay.
So every and these are important later on when the cleanup happens.
Yeah.
Because when the cleanup happens, it's going to be the most expensive part of this whole deal.
Yeah.
When they start taking out, remember, what they discovered only in the West Tower basement is very small.
Yeah.
There's a lot more underneath there. And the only reason why it all flowed into the basement at the West Tower, it is the tallest building with the deepest basement.
Yeah. So it flowed down there.
It became a collector actually of
it
the.
It became a sump.
Yeah. It became a sump. That's. So we, the second thing we need to do is design what we call capture wells. We have to get the fuel flowing.
To drain them up.
Yes. So we'll drill wells beside the building and then pump very hard so that the water will flow into the wells rather than into the building.
Wow. Para ta Iraq, no? They have oil wells.
You know, the funny thing here is this. Huh? If it wasn't the pipeline, then I said, I discovered oil in Makati, you know?
Yeah, you'll be a rich
refined.
Man. British Petroleum wants to talk to you. Well, Dr. Arcilla, thank you very much for
coming.
I'm pretty sure we'll be talking to you in future episodes of Future Perfect, because we're not going to see this problem solved overnight, right?
At least we know the problem now.
At least we know the problem. That's the first step to finding a solution. Dr. Carlos Arcilla, the director of the UP Dilima National Institute of Geological Sciences, or the NIGS. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Coming up next, we'll leave pipes for a while and we'll move on to boxes. Future Perfect's Unboxed has got a big surprise for all you Google Android fans out there. Stay tuned for that.